Good evening, teacher.
Good evening, Myra.
Teacher, I am going on the bus.
Oh.
I don't turn on the camera.
Okay. Okay, people, good evening. How are you today? Welcome to our new class.
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening.
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening.
Good evening, teacher.
Hello, good evening. Okay. How was your weekend? Think about that. I want you to tell me a little bit in few words. How was your weekend? What did you do? Where did you go? For example, my weekend was very nice. So on Saturday, as usual, my wife and I went for breakfast. So that is something we are doing on Saturdays. So we go out, we have breakfast together. Then we go shopping or because in the afternoon I work. On Saturday's afternoon from 1 to 5. That's what I did on this Saturday, okay? Then on Sunday, we stayed home in the morning. It was a nice Sunday because we looked after our granddaughter. My daughter had to work and her husband too. So we took care of we babysit our granddaughter. So she spent the day with us. We went for coffee in the afternoon. Spent time together and with our granddaughter. So it was nice having our granddaughter whole day here at home. That was my weekend, okay? So what about you? I want you to tell me quickly, a few words. How was your weekend, okay? What you did during this weekend? Right, so when I call your name for the attendance, so you say present, and then you tell me a little bit about your weekend. All right, let's start with Alejandra Vanessa Mora.
Present teacher.
Okay, Alejandra, tell us, how was your weekend?
My weekend was very good, teacher. Good.
Okay, tell me, what did you do? Where did you go? So, tell me about your weekend. What you did?
My weekend. Ah, no sé cómo decir. Estuve muy ocupado, teacher. Día muy ocupado. My day is.
Ajá. ¿Cómo decimos? ¿Cómo decimos people que estuvo ocupado? ¿Cómo?
Busy.
Busy. Okay.
Busy.
Ajá. Why, Alejandra?
My day busy, teacher.
Why? Yush. Uh-huh. So you worked?
Yes, in my work, much tareas. ¿Cómo se dice tareas?
Tasks, activities.
Activities.
Uh-huh. Okay, and Sunday? You worked on Sunday?
Sunday, ahora?
No, today is Monday. Yesterday was Sunday. Okay. Okay, okay, Vanessa, that's okay. I don't want to push you too much. Ana Delmi Herrera. Is Ana Delmi here? Ana Delmi?
Buenas noches, teacher.
Hello, Ana Delmi. How was your weekend, Ana Delmi?
Good. Yes. I am still in capacity, but for pharyngitis,
I'm
using White House work.
Ah, okay, okay. You have a disability or license. Okay, yes. Very good.
Yes.
Ana Marisol Mendoza. Ana Marisol Mendoza is here. Not yet. Ángel Alexander Guardado. Not yet. Carolina Yamilet Hernandez.
Present teacher.
Aha, Caroline. How was your weekend?
My weekend, I was with a lot of home activity, getting home, then at watching TV.
Okay.
My husband and my mother.
Ah, okay. Okay, very good. Thank you. Claudia Guadalupe Arias.
Present teacher.
Hi, Claudia. How was your weekend?
Very good, teacher. I went to visit my parents.
Oh, where do they live?
In Santiago de María.
Oh, that's a beautiful town.
Yes.
Yes, I like it. Very fresh.
Fresh. Right.
Okay, excellent.
Okay.
Claudia Yvette Samayoa. Claudia Yvette Samayoa.
Present, teacher.
Hi, Claudia. How are you?
I'm fine.
And how was your weekend?
My weekend was busy because I have classes at the university on Saturday.
Oh, what are you studying?
La licenciatura.
What kind of?
Educación.
Oh, okay. Very good. Very good. Thank you.
Okay.
Hilda Xiomara Soriano.
I'm here, teacher.
Hi, Hilda.
Hi, teacher. Fine.
Good.
Thanks.
And what about your weekend? What did you do? Where did you go?
My weekend was good because I stay at home. In Saturday, I cleaned my bedroom.
Oh.
And on Sunday, I cooked and played with my nephews.
Okay. Very good. Thank you, Xiomara.
You're welcome, Tisha.
Irma de Los Angeles Flores.
Present, teacher.
Hi, Irma. How are you today?
Hi. I was sick.
Yes, I know.
On vacation for 16 days in my bed.
Yes, you are in quarantine.
Yes.
Yes, I know. Okay. But how do you feel today? You feel better?
So.
Okay. Okay. But you sound better. You sound better than Friday. Yeah. Suena mejor que el viernes, sí.
Okay. Y ahora amaneció un poquito mejor.
Yes. Thank God for that.
Okay.
Jessica Rosemary Olmedo.
Present, teacher.
Hi, Jessica. How are you?
So, teacher.
Jessica.
Yes.
Jessica, I'm talking to you.
Hello, teacher. Present.
How are you? How was your weekend?
My weekend was good. Good for you.
Speak to me.
Teacher, listen to me.
How was your weekend? What did you do? Where did you go?
I went to visit my grandparents. Weekend was good.
I don't hear you. Okay, maybe later. Joanna Beatriz Orellana.
Teacher.
Hi, Joanna. How are you?
I'm tired, teacher.
Tired? Why?
Because I went to the hospital every day.
Really?
Yes, I went to the hospital in San Rafael, and then I went to Santa Anita.
Oh, are you sick?
Yes, teacher.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. I hope you feel better, okay?
Okay, teacher. Thanks.
Karina Melissa Estrada. Karina Melissa. No? Not here. Linda Stephanie Ramirez. No? Mayra Roxana Hernández.
Yes, teacher.
Hi, Mayra. Oh, you're on the bus. Okay, we'll talk later. I'll talk to you later. Okay, good. Thank you. Miguel Ángel Domínguez.
How are you, Ángel?
I'm good. I'm good. And you?
Very good, teacher.
Okay, what about your weekend? How was your weekend? What did you do? Where did you go?
My weekend is nice.
Why? Tell us.
With my family.
Uh-huh.
Relaxed?
What did you do to relax?
Maybe watching Netflix.
Okay, very good. Thank you. Nelson Ivan Alfaro.
Present, teacher.
Hi, Nelson. How are you?
I'm fine.
How was your weekend?
My weekend was excellent.
Oh, that's great.
I stand by with my family, watching the general conference of the church, and I am teaching many things about the
general conference. What conference?
Of the church.
Oh, okay, okay. Very good. Okay. Olga Marlene Gomez.
Good evening, teacher.
Hi, Olga. How was your weekend? Tell us.
My weekend was very busy because I'm very tasked in my house, and I went to my daughter at the park. And I'm create the website for the store.
Oh.
My store. In Sunday, my father-in-law and my husband, they went for the third doses, the vaccine anti-COVID.
The first?
First, no, third.
Third, okay.
Third. Yes.
Excellent.
And then we went at home. I'm very, very busy again.
Okay, very good. Very good. Excellent. Thank you.
Okay.
Zenaida America Dominguez. Zenaida. Zenaida, not there. Okay, Silvia Suleyma Rodriguez.
Good night, teacher.
Hi, good evening, Silvia.
Good evening, excuse me.
No problem. And you tell me, how was your weekend?
My weekend was very, very nice in my house. The Saturday I stay in my house, and yesterday in the morning went to supermarket, and in the afternoon play with my daughter.
Ah, okay, okay, very good. Excellent, thank you. Okay. Silvio Enrique Cortez.
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening, Silvio. How are you?
I'm fine.
Good. And what about your weekend? How was your weekend?
My weekend was very relaxed. I stayed in my house and I work and reports and Saturday in the morning. Oh, only okay. That.
Okay, very good. Excellent. Carlos Alberto Melendez.
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening, Carlos. How are you today?
I'm fine.
Good. And how was your weekend?
It's very cool. I did rest all weekend. And Sunday, I did wake up late. I'm playing with my son.
Okay, excellent. Very good. Very good. And Carla Veronica Suria. Carla Veronica.
Hello, good evening. Present.
Good evening, Carla. And you, Carla, how was your weekend?
Very good.
Why?
Because I went to the supermarket. I went to the church in the afternoon and homework house.
Okay, very good. Okay, people, welcome one more time. We are going to do this kind of exercise maybe every day or every 2 days, 2 or 3 times a week, because the idea is to learn to communicate here, okay? We are not here just to go and fill a book, okay, and just finish with a book. So you are here to learn to speak. And I like to ask you questions about past activities, because sometimes it's one of the more difficult tenses for the students at the beginning. Okay. So please be prepared. Okay. So, and the idea is to speak. So don't think that we are wasting time. No piense, estamos perdiendo el tiempo. Ya entrémosle a la clase. Sí, estábamos en la clase. Estaba escuchándolo. Los demás deben de poner atención. Lamento que yo no sé qué pasa con la clase, que no se acostumbran a encender sus cámaras. ¿Verdad? La mayoría vean cámaras apagadas y no es... Es un requisito de INSAFORP, y lo que pasa es que luego no están ahí, no están escuchando a los demás, y aprendemos no solo del teacher, aprendemos unos de otros. Ok, entonces por favor estemos acá presente, ¿no? Llamo a algunos, si no contestan, obviamente apagaron la cámara, se levantaron, se fueron al baño, a cenar, a hacer el café, qué sé yo.
Hola. Una ¿cómo decirle? En mi caso, ¿verdad?
Sí.
Yo apago la cámara porque la clase la recibo desde el teléfono. Sí. Entonces siento de que cuando tengo encendida la cámara, se me corta o le oigo a usted, se me traba más y le escucho a usted más entrecortado.
Sí. Sí, yo sé que eso pasa, yo sé que eso pasa.
En la clase yo creo que debemos de estar conscientes de que es una bendición y una oportunidad bonita que tenemos para aprender.
Exacto.
Quienes estamos conscientes creo que lo hacemos.
Claro. Yo no digo que siempre sea el caso de todo, ¿verdad? Yo entiendo que a veces eso pasa, ¿no? el internet no es muy bueno, al encender la cámara se complica la señal, ok, perfecto. Pero espero que cuando sí les llamo, que estén con la cámara apagada, si están ahí, rápido me van a responder. Ok, entonces eso me demuestra que sí están ahí. Y por otro lado, yo siempre les digo, miren, esto, si bien es cierto, en este momento para cada curso usted no está sacando los 70, 80 dólares de cada módulo, no los está sacando en el momento de su bolsa, pero óigame, esto a usted se lo descuentan mensualmente en su planilla, ¿verdad? Usted da un aporte para el INSAFORP. Ustedes, de lo que le descuentan del seguro, hay algo que va para INSAFORP. O sea, no le estoy diciendo con eso, pues lo estoy pagando. No, lo que le estoy diciendo es, aproveche, porque de todas maneras estamos invirtiendo nuestro dinero, ¿verdad?, en INSAFORP. Entonces aprovechemos los cursos que proporciona INSAFORP, ¿no? Porque es un recurso que también sale de nuestro bolsillo, ¿ok? Del descuento que le hacen. Así es que afortunadamente no lo sacan en el momento de su bolsa, pero con el tiempo usted está invirtiendo en esto y aproveche la opción que se le brinda a través de eso, ¿no? Ok, y esto, esa es la idea, hablar, soltar la lengua. O sea, no vamos a terminar el curso y no nos vamos a poder expresar. La idea no es que al terminar el curso ustedes digan, no, mire, yo lo leo y yo lo entiendo, pero mi problema es hablarlo. Eso es lo que yo escucho de muchos estudiantes. Mire, teacher, es que yo lo leo, yo lo entiendo, pero hablarlo no me sale. Bueno, hablemos aquí, ¿verdad? Les hago preguntas, ¿qué hicieron? ¿Cómo estuvo tu fin de semana? ¿Qué hiciste ayer? ¿Dónde fuiste? ¿Qué comiste? Y así vamos a estar hablando, ¿no? No solamente para, bueno, qué bueno que ya lean y que ya puedan leer y pronunciar bien las lecturas y las conversaciones del libro. Pero no es eso lo que vamos a hablar toda la vida, ¿no? Se tiene que aprender a expresar sus ideas. Entonces, esté listo para esto, ¿no? Aunque nos lleve unos minutos del inicio de la clase. ¿Qué hicieron? ¿Qué hiciste? ¿Dónde estuviste? ¿Cómo estuvo? ¿No? Y a conversar ahí. Ay, teacher, es que a mí me da pena. Y eso es otra cosa que tiene que vencer. ¿Ok? Eso es otra cosa que se tiene que vencer. La pena, ¿no? A veces no es falta de capacidad, sino la pena. ¿Qué van a decir? Pues, ¿qué le importa qué van a decir? Usted va a los gringos que andan aquí, ¿verdad?, enchancletados y todos peludos y hablan ahí, ¿verdad?, como les salga. Y ya, o sea, igual, entonces igual nosotros no perdamos esa pena. Ok, dicho eso, let's get started, let's continue with our class, ok. Let me share the screen here and we go to the Monday. Last class, we are about a question about the product, okay? So, and the answers in your groups, okay? The first question says, what does Kirk's friend, which is job, what does Kirk's friend do to have better honey quality? Do you remember? What does Kirk's friend do? No, it's not job. Job is another person. So Kirk was talking about a friend who has a honey factory. Yeah, you know, a friend of mine has a honey factory. What does this friend do to have better honey quality? Okay, I hear you. Tell me. What does he do?
He does fresh honey from local farmer, maybe.
Okay, yes. He got fresh honey from local farmers. Perfect. That's what he did, or what he does to have better honey quality. He gets fresh honey from local farmers. Good. And the second question is about your opinion. Do you consider that quality is important? What do you think? Is quality important? Yes or no?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, right. Yes. So definitely it is important. But the question is, why? Why is quality important for a business, for a company? Why is quality important?
Uh-huh. It's important because if you send, if you sell a bad product, it's probably you don't sell your product.
Okay, good. What else? What is another reason you wrote? Uh-huh.
Yes, it's important because you can have a very product on the market with new customer. In addition to being one of the best on the market.
Okay, good. So what do you prefer when you are going to purchase or to buy a product? Price or quality?
Quality.
Okay. Okay. Good. So, do you pay for good quality?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
Yes, right. Because sometimes people think, no, it is too expensive. People is not going to buy my product because quality is expensive. So I'm going to sell a bad product, but cheap. Yeah. Maybe the customers are going to buy once your product, but when they see that it's a bad product, they will not come back. Yes,
this is the point.
That's the point, exactly, right? So if you go to a pupuseria and the pupusas are bad, will you come back to that pupuseria?
No.
Okay, but they were cheap. Their weight just 1/4. Yeah, but they were bad. Okay, but the other pupuseria, the pupusas are 75 cents. But they are good. Yeah, I paid the 75 cents for a good pupusa. Definitely. Okay, or 80 or $1. Yeah, if it's good, I pay. Okay, so quality is very important. Now, let's see this topic. Let me share here. In this class, we're going to learn how to use what clauses. What clauses? Okay, let me read this. What clauses are often the subject of the verb be, which can be followed by a word, phrase, or a clause? Look, these are some what clauses. Clauses are phrases that alone, they don't have any meaning. O sea, sola, una cláusula sola no significa nada. Yeah? For example, what you need, okay. So the idea is not complete. Finish. Tell me what I need. What you need is to have a great product. Ah, okay, that is the complete idea. And we have here the verb be. What you need is the second example. What my friend did. What my friend did was get fresh ingredients. Ah, what my friend did was get fresh ingredients. Where is verb be in this sentence?
Was.
Was, correct. Okay, was is verb be in this sentence. Good. What I would do is sell my product in new market. Again, verb be. What I'm saying is that it is not an easy task. Verb be here. Okay. And this phrase or clause is the subject of the sentence. What I need is, oops. What you need is, so this is the subject of the sentence. What my friend did was, what I would do is, what I'm saying is, so that clause is the subject of the sentence of the verb be. Okay, what you need is to have a great product. What my friend did was get fresh ingredients. What I would do is sell my product in new markets. What I'm saying is that it is not an easy task. Okay, so this is what we call what clauses. All right. Now, look at these sentences. You have to complete these sentences using these four clauses. Okay? My best friend just opened his own shop. Anana was opening in a good mall. Many people want to start their own business. Is lots of information. I don't know where she has to start. Is promote the products online. People don't buy new products because they can't. Da-da-da, is there is no demand. Okay, using these phrases or these clauses, complete these four sentences, okay? I will give you like what, 3 minutes to do it.
Otro entorno cerrado. Horas de sol. Las tres personas presentes llevan mascarilla y amarillas los aerosoles que producen agua. Estas gotitas pueden permanecer en el aire durante.
las frases quizá deban adaptarlas un poco, ¿verdad? En algunas oraciones, no solo copiarlas exactamente como están. Por ejemplo, voy a dar un ejemplo con la primera. Dice, my best friend just opened his own shop. Okay. Aquí podemos decir, let me change the color. What he did was open it in a good mall. You see?
Teacher, in this case, another example, maybe was my best friend deal was open it in a good mood.
Yes, yeah, I just use this the pronoun he, but it, yes, you can use one my best friend deal.
Okay, thank you. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so this is the way to do it, okay? So, and I use this one. Okay, what about number two? Who can give me number two? Many people want to start their own business.
What you need is...
What you need. Okay, but... Yeah, the clause is correct, but I would change you because we are talking about many people. What pronoun can we use?
They.
Correct.
They.
We are talking about many people, so it's better to use they. What they need is lots of information. Correct. Okay, what about number three? I don't know where she has to start. Okay, and we use the what they need, what you need. We use this first one. Nos quedan dos. Okay, who wants to give me number three?
Teacher, number four, no sé si sería what I am saying.
Okay, let's go to number four. What I'm saying, okay, yeah. What I'm saying is there is no demand. And this is number four. Okay, so number three.
I will need it's la última.
Okay, but look, I don't know where she has to start. ¿Cómo la colocamos?
What she will do.
Yes, what she would do is promote the products online. Okay, very good, very good. So these are what clauses, okay? And this, we use them in this way. All right. Now, okay, I will give you a minute if you want to take note. Okay, let's continue. Now, what you are going to do, and well, let me show you an example. The idea is that you are going to talk about a product or a service that your company offers, okay? Let me show you an example. Let me think, is this one? Okay. Look at this. What clauses? So these are different things, okay? Not the exact words, but these are what clauses. For example, I am going to talk about my company, Inglés Corporativo, okay? If what you need is to learn English, what we offer is the best teaching methodology. What our employees do is teach you with energy and professionalism. What you are going to receive is online or on-site classes full of educational activities. What other companies offer is obsolete methods at high prices. Yeah.
T-shirt.
Uh-huh.
Excuse me, what does mean clauses?
Clauses are like phrases. Phrases, but they are not sentences. But the difference with a clause and a sentence is that a sentence has meaning alone. Una oración tiene un sentido, significado por sí sola, ¿ok? Pero una cláusula no. Necesita algo más, ¿verdad? Para complementarse. Eso es una clause, ¿ok?
Thank you, teacher.
Ok, vean, este es el ejemplo que yo les doy. Y quiero, van a usar estas mismas clauses.
Teacher, excuse me.
Uh-huh.
What is the traduction, the first clauses? If what you need is traduction to Spanish.
If, what is if?
Sí.
Uh-huh. What you need is to learn English. A ver, vamos, yo sé que le puedes encontrar el sentido. If what you need is to learn English.
Si tú necesitas. Pero what? Es que por eso es confundida what? Por el what.
Ah, vamos, vamos. Si tú necesitas es.
Aprende.
¿Cómo traducimos el what?
¿Qué onda, Emma?
¿Lo qué?
Ajá, ¿alguien lo dijo ya por ahí? Repeat.
¿Lo qué?
¿Lo qué?
¿Cómo quedaría la frase? Esas, toda esa frase, ¿cómo quedaría?
Lo que tú necesitas es
inglés.
Aprender inglés. Aprender inglés.
Si lo que tú necesitas es aprender inglés. Ajá. Ok. If what you need is to learn English, what we offer is the best teaching methodology. What our employees do is teach you with energy and professionalism. What you are going to receive is online or on-site classes full of educational activities. What other companies offer is obsolete methods at high prices. Simple. Ahora, aquí quiero que piensen en your company. Okay? Van a hacer esto, pero no de inglés corporativo. Think about your company. Okay? And what your company offers. ¿Qué ofrece su compañía? ¿Qué, verdad? Si lo que tú necesitas es, qué sé yo, material eléctrico, what we offer is, nosotros te ofrecemos variedad en marcas y qué sé yo. What our employees do is, ¿ya? Quiero que usen estas mismas frases para hablarme de su empresa.
Teacher, for example, I work in the hotel. If you want, if you need enjoy your vacation.
To need
come the hotel. For example.
No, pero y hay que ir parte por parte, va. If what you need is to enjoy your vacation, what we offer is this, this, and this, and that. What our employees do is esto, 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 y esto. What you are going to receive is esto, 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 y esto. What other companies offer is esto, 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 y esto.
Ah, okay. ¿Ya? Thank you.
Me van a hablar de su compañía usando estas clauses. ¿Ok? Lo que su compañía es, lo que ofrece, lo que los trabajadores de su compañía hacen, ¿verdad? O ofrecen. Usando esas 5 frases. Prepárenme y háblenme de su compañía. En ese tipo de oraciones, ¿ok? Les voy a poner el ejemplo este ahí en el WhatsApp para que lo vean como modelo. Bueno, que aquí lo pueden ver, pero bueno, para que les quede. Ok. Ahí les queda. Trabajen, les voy a dar unos minutos. Y luego nos van a presentar su compañía de esta manera. tienen alguna pregunta de lo que van a hacer, pues aquí estoy.
Teacher, how do you say moda?
Moda, fashion.
Yeah, fashion, okay.
Teacher.
Yes.
Teacher. ¿Puede poner las cláusulas otra vez, por favor?
Ok.
Teacher, disculpe, ¿cuál es la actividad que estamos haciendo? Porque a mí me sacó el internet, ya no pude ver.
Ah, ok. Bueno, usando estas, aquí les he puesto yo un ejemplo, ¿verdad? Acerca de my company, inglés corporativo, ¿verdad? Como yo les hablo de inglés corporativo usando estas frases, estas clauses. ¿Ya?
Okay.
Usando estas cláusulas, estas clauses, yo les hablo de inglés corporativo. If what you need is to learn English, what we offer is the best teaching methodology. What our employees do is teach you with energy and professionalism. What you are going to receive is online or on-site classes full of educational activities. What other companies offer is obsolete methods at high prices. Ahora lo que quiero que en esta parte, en lugar de ser inglés corporativo, ustedes me hablen de su compañía.
Ok, gracias.
¿Verdad? Usando estas mismas cláusulas. que vaya terminando me pone la manita levantada. No la del pulgar porque esa se borra. La de levantar la mano, esta que he puesto yo, para saber que ya terminaron.
Teacher.
Hola.
Fíjense que aquí estaba revisando el libro y información aparte, pero la verdad que no le entiendo a eso de las cláusulas. Así que no sé si voy a esperar que mis compañeros hagan el ejercicio para ver tal vez si comprendo de qué trata, porque no le hay.
Lo que les acabo de explicar.
Ajá, pero es que, o sea, no le entiendo el uso.
Es, pero la actividad que les acabo de explicar, ¿sí comprendes lo que vas a hacer?
Ah, que tenemos que como describir nuestra compañía. Y la, ajá, pero ¿cómo meter el what? O sea, eso es mi duda.
Ahí está, en las frases que yo te he puesto ahí. Esas mismas frases son las que quiero que utilices. Son ejemplos de este tipo de cláusulas, what clauses.
Voy a intentar.
¿Verdad? Sí, es que no, te digo, son muchas frases que en la vida usamos que comienzan con ese what, ¿verdad? Y que es lo que se llaman what clauses.
Ok, teacher, voy a ver si me sale.
Ok.
Igual, teacher, yo no entendí el contexto de vi varios tiempos, vi presente, ¿sí? Simple, pasado.
Es que estas what clauses son simplemente frases que utilizas con el qué. ¿Qué? ¿Verdad?
Para pero ¿tiene algo, una estructura? ¿Tiene no, algún tiempo? No, simple.
Puedes usar en diferentes formas, diferentes tiempos. O sea, lo que yo te recomiendo es simplemente ese verbo to be. ¿Verdad? Entonces, te lo dices a alguien así. What I recommend is. What you should do is. Lo que debiste hacer. Pasado. ¿Verdad? Lo que podemos hacer es. O sea, todo ese tipo de frases, esas son what clauses. ¿Ya?
Bueno.
Voy a tomar la segunda asistencia mientras trabajan. Si es que se encienden sus cámaras, por favor, para la asistencia. Alejandra Vanessa Mora.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Ana Delmi Herrera.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Ana Marisol Mendoza.
Present.
Okay. Ángel Alexander Guardado.
Present, teacher.
Good. Carolina Yamilet Hernández.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Claudia Guadalupe Arias.
Present, teacher. Okay.
Claudia Ivette Samayoa.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Hilda Xiomara Soriano. Micrófono.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Irma de Los Ángeles Flores.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Jessica Rosemary Olmedo.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Joana Beatriz Orellana.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Karina Melissa Estrada. Karina Melissa Estrada. Linda Stephanie Ramírez. Mayra Roxana Hernández.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Miguel Ángel Domínguez.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Nelson Iván Alfaro.
Present.
Good. Olga Marlene Gómez.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Zenaida América Domínguez. Zenaida Domínguez.
Present, teacher. I'm sorry, but I used the phone with my homework.
Okay. Silvia Zuleima Rodríguez.
Present, teacher.
Good. Silvia Enrique Cortés.
Present.
Okay. Carlos Alberto Meléndez.
Present.
And Carla Verónica Suria.
Present.
Okay.
Teacher.
Hola.
I think I'm finished. I think.
Okay.
But you say me it's good or it's bad.
Teacher, I think.
Okay. I told teacher.
Yeah. Okay. Yes. Vamos a Xiomara.
Yes. I work in the prel. I sell the motorcycles spare parts. Entonces la conversación va así. If what you need is to buy motorcycle spare parts, what we offer is a quality product. What our employees do is show you product of different quality and price.
Uh-huh.
What you are going to receive is exactly what you needed, what okay. You decide. Okay. You need and decide.
Okay.
what other companies offer is lower quality.
Okay, excellent. Perfect.
Thanks, teacher.
Yes, eso es.
Thanks.
That's it. Exacto.
Me, teacher.
Finish.
Okay, okay. Yeah, yeah. Take it easy. Take it easy. Quiero que terminen y primero los voy a enviar a grupos para que ahí practiquen y luego nos reunimos todos y ahí algunos si, o todos, ¿verdad? Si nos queda tiempo, los vamos a escuchar. ¿Ok? Si es que, a ver, los que no han levantado la mano, ¿es que no han terminado? O si me levantan la manita ahí para ver que ya terminaron. Excellent. Muy bien. Ya casi todos.
Teacher, aparece mi mano levantada.
No, es que pusiste la del saludito. En la que hay que poner es la que dice levantar la mano.
Ok.
Exacto, esa. Un minuto más y vamos a armar los grupos. Okay, so los voy a enviar a los grupos. Compartan ahí lo que hicieron, ¿verdad? Talk about your company using those what clauses, and then we are going to come back together, and we are going to listen your presentation. Okay. Go to your groups, please. I will give you 5 minutes.
for climate change. What you are going to receive is support with supplies and professional and training staff. What other companies offer is momentary help without follow-up.
Right, very nice.
Okay.
Ahora mi turno.
Medical history prescribed by appropriate medication for each case.
Okay. Medicamentos.
Okay, sí, compañías.
En español, yo trabajo con un psiquiatra de niños y adolescentes, ¿verdad? Y bueno, ¿qué necesita? Si tú necesitas una buena salud mental, ¿verdad? ¿Qué es lo que ofrecen?
Why are you saying that in Spanish?
Ah, porque ya se lo dije en inglés, teacher. Okay. Y quieren que les explique de qué se trata.
No, must be in English.
Okay.
Okay. That's fine.
Les decía que es para tener una mejor calidad de vida, ¿verdad? ¿Y qué es lo que ofrecen los
LES? S A L E S, advisor.
Okay. Advisor.
Advisor. A
advisor.
A B I S O R.
R. Okay. Advisor.
Yes.
Es asesor. Asesor. Sí. Bien. Okay.
El tópico.
Sí, o sea, ¿con qué gramatical? ¿Para qué te va a servir?
Tiempo y todo eso. Pero bueno.
Sí, sí. Yo igual que ella, yo, o sea, en la segunda, en el what we offer is puse is good food and cause your own to your the clients, o sea, clientes, buena comida y clientes, habitaciones confortables para nuestros clientes.
¿En qué hotel trabaja usted?
Ah, en uno pequeño aquí en Suchitoto. Medianito, no tanto como el suyo, no grande así como el suyo.
¿Tienes algunas inquietudes ahí, Silvio? Me parece que no estás, no sé, claro, satisfecho.
Sí, no, para nada, teacher. No veo que estemos utilizando una pedagogía adecuada para explicar los temas. Sinceramente, pues, también así como usted está invirtiendo tiempo, igual estamos invirtiendo nosotros. No vi el contexto, el contexto del uso de las cláusulas, los tiempos.
Vimos la conversación ahí el viernes. ¿Viste tú el uso de las cláusulas en la conversación?
Sí, por eso le digo. O sea, por ejemplo, ahí vimos, veo que se están usando, no sé si son tres tiempos diferentes o si haya una estructura definida, porque más o menos, digamos que como estamos aprendiendo, eso es lo que vemos, ¿verdad? Una estructura del el double question, el subject, el tiempo, el verbo
pasado. Sí, pero es que presente. Este no es un tiempo gramatical.
Esto pero no sí es. Lo estoy usando en diferentes tiempos, el presente, el pasado, el ¿qué? Presente continuo, creo que es.
Puedes usar en todos los tiempos. Pero no te puedo enseñar esto en todos los tiempos. Hemos visto todos los tiempos. ¿Verdad? ¿Qué te puedo decir? Son frases, ¿verdad? Para explicar simplemente algo que tú usas, un what. Se llaman what clauses o cláusulas que comienzan con what, pero no son preguntas. ¿Ya? Entonces, si tú me quieres, si yo te pregunto, ok, what, what would you do if you go to another country? Okay, what I would do is visit the famous places. This is una clause. What clause? What I would do is. What do you need to what do you need to get the job? What I need is to speak English. That is another what clause. What did you eat yesterday? What I ate was pizza. Entonces, no hay una estructura básica. Simplemente son what, frases que comienzas con what, que vas a para usar para explicar algo que, y que en este contexto lo estamos usando para explicar de un producto o de una, de tu compañía, lo que hace tu compañía. Okay. Okay, people, welcome back. I'd like to hear your description about your companies, okay? So, volunteer to start.
Me, teacher.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay. My company, teacher, is una boutique. If what your need is look good. What we offer is nice place, good and chic, and good price. What your employer do is other offer through respect to the client.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. What you're going to receive is warranty and quality. Okay. What other companies offer is garment, but in fashion and distinction. Distinction.
Okay.
Finish.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. Okay, Irma.
Me, teacher.
Who? Who said me?
Me. Irma, teacher.
Okay, bueno. Levanten la manito ahí para irles, ahí me los va ubicando el Zoom a los que quieren ir participando, ¿ok?
Teacher, Irma habló.
Sí, sí, Irma, gracias. Thank you. Excellent. Okay, Carlos.
Okay, is what you need is identify carbonate beverage. You need labels is a what? We offer is the best labels with the high quality colors. And what our employees do is help you for solving your necessities. And what you're going to recite is labels, the high colors and quality. And what other company offer is obsolete machines and poor quality colors at highest cost.
Excellent, very good. Thank you, Carlos. I'll look for you if I need labels. Okay, Miguel Angel.
Right, teacher. My company offers service of aduana. And if what you need is one service more innovation. What we offer is good service, competitive. What our employees do is very good. What you are going to receive is gratifying. And what other companies offer is so important in national level.
Okay. Finish. Perfect. Thank you. Very good. Myra.
Teacher. In my case, the business is the clothes. Mm-hmm. Is what you need is a new clothes and an accessory. What we offer is the last fashion clothes. What our employees do is attend with passion and polite. What you are going to receive are the best clothes of the quality and attention. What other company offer is different products, but I guarantee that you will be satisfied with our quality.
Perfect. Very good. Thank you. Silvia. Hello, Silvia.
Okay. If what you need is have money, what we offer is credit with the best interest. What our employees do is attend you with quality and efficient. What you are going to receive is the best and quickly product. What other companies offer is a bad service.
Oh, everybody needs money. Okay, I need money. Okay, Claudia.
Okay. If what you need is, we are financial service. What we offer is to portfolio of financial products. What our employees do is, they give a professional and friendly service to customers. What you are going to receive is excellent service and financial support. What other companies offer is there is not solid financial support.
Okay, thank you. Very good. Olga.
Yes, teacher. My company is an NGO. Is what you need is to save the human survival.
What we offer is capacity about resilience and food sovereignty. What our employees do is train people for climate change. What you are going to receive is support with supplies and professional and trained staff. What other companies offer is momentary help without follow-up.
Ah, okay, very interesting. Thank you. Excellent. Okay, Caroline.
Okay. In my company is Dr. Otto Moises Castro. If what you need it is to have good mental health, what we offer is see life in a better way. What host employees do is offer personalized attention for each case. What you are going to receive is a good orientation and necessary medications. What not other companies offer is they do not offer a complete psychiatric evaluation, taking the patient's medical history, prescribing appropriate medication for each case.
Wow, very interesting. Thank you very much. Very good. Okay, Claudia. Claudia Yvette.
Okay. If what you need is nice and cheap shoes. What we offer is quality, variety of style and durability in footwear. What our employees do is offer the best service to our clients. What you are going to receive is a quality product. What other companies offer is a classic product without quality.
Okay, very good, excellent. A ver, ¿quién falta? Faltan varios.
Mi teacher.
Okay, Joanna.
A ver, está bueno. If what you need is to buy a computer, what we offer is the best price to you. What our employees do is call you monthly. What you are going to receive is ticket online. What other company offer is best price to our customer.
Okay, okay, good, very good.
No está mal.
No, it's okay, but maybe what other companies offer is better prices than you.
No sé. Ay, no, teacher, me la ha puesto bien fea ahora.
No, porque la pregunta, la frase es, lo que otras compañías te ofrecen es, y yo escuché que dijiste better prices. Y era como...
Bad price.
Ah, ok. O higher prices, precios más altos, ¿verdad?
To the customers.
Yes, higher prices, pudiera decir. Que no creo que presentes tu producto diciendo que los otros ofrecen mejor precio. Okay. Okay, but the idea is good. A ver, ¿quién falta?
Me teach.
Okay.
If what you need is to stay relaxed, uh-huh. What we offer is the best beach hotel. Uh-huh. What our employees do is to feel at home. What you are going to receive is a personal service.
Okay.
And what other hotel offer is higher prices and you don't feel comfortable.
Ah, wow. What hotel is?
Palo Verde.
Palo Verde.
La Libertad. Yes.
Oh, I need one weekend.
Yes.
Palo Verde. Okay, we are going to talk.
Okay.
Me too.
Yeah, okay. We can go with the group. Ah, excellent. Thank you. Next. I know who's missing, so no me hagan que los llame uno por uno a los que faltan.
Me, teacher.
Okay, Alejandra.
Okay. If what you need, bueno, my company is Shop Sara. If what you need is to say clothes, what we offer is the best customer service. What our employee do is a sales advisor. And what you are going to receive is excellent service. And what other companies offer is the best quality and shopping experience.
Other companies. Esa última creo que no la han comprendido algunos, ¿no? What other companies offer. La competencia. ¿Qué ofrece la competencia? What other companies offer is...
Mala calidad.
Okay. That's the idea. Esa última frase. Okay. But in general, good. Okay. ¿Qué me falta?
Mi teacher.
Okay, adelante.
My company, distribuidora salvadoreña CADCB, is what you need is liquor and beer. What we offer is a great portfolio of national, international liquor and beer.
Wow.
What our employees do is offer the most excellent product quality and service to offer customer. What you are going to reserve is quality at good price. Uh-huh. What offer company offer is they do not have a large portfolio and higher in cost.
Oh, very good, very good. Okay, you need liquor and beer at good price and good quality. Talk to Anadelmi. Okay, for Christmas, for New Year, graduations.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, okay. Next.
Me, Tisha.
Okay, Zenaida.
If what you need is enjoy your vacation, what we offer is an all-inclusive food, drink, accommodation, security, fun. What our employees do is welcome you with great joy and willing to place you. What you are going to receive is service, attitude, and charisma. How do you say charisma in English?
Yeah, charisma.
Charisma. What other companies offer is only accommodation and you pay food and drink.
Hey, where is that?
I so, don't understand.
Where is that? So what company is?
Royal Decameron Salinitas, El Salvador.
Oh, okay. Good, very good. Excellent.
Ya tenemos reservation.
Yes, yeah, special prices. We can go to Palo Verde, the Cameron.
To hotel, the beer.
We have liquor, beers. Liquor.
What you can eat is all you can eat, all you can drink is.
Yeah, very good, Zenaida. Thank you. Okay, who's missing? I'm missing Silvio, Angel, Jessica. Are you going to participate?
Teacher.
Okay, Jessica.
Okay. Lo intenté porque no entendí mucho el tema. Dice nada más tres frases. Dice, what do you need is to offer better service. What my company did was improve its service. And what my company offers are good service.
Okay, what kind of service?
Countable.
Ah, countable service. So yes. If what I need is an accountant, what you offer is accounting services. Yes? Okay. And what your employees do is, I don't know, to give professional accounting service?
Yes. Yeah.
That is the idea, to talk about your products and your company using those examples. Okay, very good.
Thank you, teacher.
Okay, Angel, Silvio.
Okay, teacher. And my company is hotel.
Okay,
my company is what you need is satisfied clients to grow in the wheel. Mm-hmm. What we offer is good food and cozy rooms to yours the clients.
Okay.
What you going to receive? The satisfaction is a good smile.
Okay.
What other the companies offers is similar. A company is similar, but never the same is over service.
Ah, okay. That's a difference. Ah. And what is the hotel? What is the name of the hotel?
It's hotel. My work is hotel in reality.
Ah, okay. Very good. Perfect. Okay.
Okay, thank you.
Who else? What about Silvio? Do you do something, Silvio? No. Okay, I'm sorry to hear that.
I don't understand the topic, teacher.
Okay, maybe we can talk when you have the personal session. Okay. Actually, Ana Delmi is here. No, Ana Marisol. Yeah, she's here. Okay. Well, what time is it? We have 10 minutes. Well, these are just some examples of clauses now that we have in the book. Yeah. So let's talk a little bit about this. So let's review this again. ¿De qué estamos hablando? Bueno, what clauses? So are often the subject of the verb be. Estas son cláusulas. Les decía que cláusulas son frases que no son en sí oraciones, porque no tienen sentido por sí solas. Eso es una cláusula. No, frases en este caso que no tienen sentido solas, sino que necesitan otra, algo más, un complemento. Y este tipo de cláusulas comienzan con what, usualmente son el sujeto del verbo to be, o sea, van atadas al verbo to be, van muy atadas al verbo to be. Por eso veíamos al principio que todas vemos que tenemos el verbo to be. What you need is. What my friend did was. What I would do is. What I'm saying is. ¿Verdad? Ok. Estos son algunos ejemplos de ocasiones en que usamos ese tipo de frases.
Sure.
¿Sí?
The clauses are the subject.
Exacto. Se convierten en el sujeto de la frase y del verbo to be. ¿Verdad? Por eso dice que la cláusula puede ser seguida por una palabra, por una frase o por una cláusula. Por ejemplo, si yo digo, what you need is... Ah, como dice aquella famosa canción, what you need is love. Eso solo es una palabra. What you need is
love.
Coffee. Ah, yeah, that's true. Okay, what you need is coffee. Pero acá no es una palabra, es una frase. What you need is to have a great product. En lo que usamos en el ejercicio. Si lo que tú necesitas, if what you need is good liquor and beer. Es una frase. Sí, dígame.
¿Y esto para qué me sirve?
Para explicar algo. ¿Verdad? Para explicar una idea. ¿Qué hicimos en el ejercicio? Explicamos nuestra compañía. Lo que ofrece. Lo que los empleados hacen. Lo que el cliente puede obtener. Lo que satisfacen con su compañía. ¿Ya? Por eso es que el ejercicio es ese, ¿no? A presentation about a product from your company. Estamos hablando de nuestra compañía. Ustedes me hablaron del servicio de su compañía, los que son servicios. Otros me hablaron del producto de su compañía. Licor, ropa. ¿Ok? Y otros del servicio. Entonces, me dieron importante información de su producto usando frases que comienzan con what. Ese es este tema. No es una estructura gramatical, no es un tiempo gramatical, ¿verdad? Sino son frases que comienzan con qué. Lo que mi amigo hizo es, lo que yo haría es, lo que quiero decir es, son estas frases que están acá. Las que usamos en el ejercicio eran diferentes, ¿verdad? Y como me preguntaba por ahí Silvio, ¿en qué tiempo están? Bueno, podemos usar cualquier tiempo, presente, pasado, futuro. No, what you need is, eso es en presente. What my friend did was, pasado. What I would do is, es presente. ¿Verdad? Entonces, eso es esto.
Por ejemplo, what I told you
was, or what I told you was not to go. Lo que te dije es que no fueras.
Entonces, después del verbo que esté en el tiempo que estemos usando, le sigue, perdón, el to be con el tiempo que estemos usando, ¿verdad?
Exacto, exacto.
Sería el verbo en el tiempo que estemos usando más el to be con el tiempo.
Okay. Ya. Yeah. El tiempo no lo determina el to be. Es el tiempo. Ok.
Teacher, for example, uh-huh. If no, what I was study, I'm a professional. Si yo hubiese estudiado.
No, vea que ahí no está usando un qué.
Ah, no.
Lo que yo estudié. Ahí pudiera decir, what I studied was English.
Ajá.
Lo que yo estudié era inglés. What I studied was English. O what I studied is English. Lo que yo estudié es inglés. Ya, depende de lo que quiera decir.
Ok, teacher. Thanks.
No. Por ejemplo, say, what I ate for breakfast is cereal and milk. Eso es todo esto, ¿no? No es una estructura gramatical, no es un... un tiempo verbal. No, son frases que comienzan con what. Y que pueden ser muchas, o sea, de todo lo que usted quiera hablar y decir. Por eso no hay una estructura que mostrar.
Y todo, teacher, excuse me, y siempre van a comenzar con what.
Depende de lo que usted esté diciendo, porque por ejemplo teníamos una ahí que decíamos if what you need is, empezamos con el if, ¿verdad? Si lo que tú necesitas es. Uh-huh. ¿Ya? Pero la frase en sí, what.
Okay.
¿Verdad? Thank
you.
Bueno, es que no sé qué es lo que están buscando. Un patrón, están buscando un patrón y aquí no hay un patrón. ¿Verdad? Si es lo que están buscando es un patrón, aquí no hay un patrón porque esto es algo muy abierto. Son todas esas frases que usted puede decir con el what, ¿verdad? Lo que yo quiero es que te vayas. What I want is you to leave. Okay, leave me alone. So, eso es una what clause. Lo que yo quiero es. Yeah. Eso es esto. Nada más. Okay. Okay, I'm going to take the last attendance. ¿Sí? ¿Alguien iba a decir algo? Ok, let's see. Alejandra Vanessa Mora. Alejandra Vanessa.
Teacher, present teacher.
Ok, thank you for attending. Anadelmi Herrera Morales.
Present teacher. Thank
you. Ana Marisol Mendoza Pineda.
Present.
Ok, Ana Marisol, tenemos la sesión personalizada hoy.
Yes.
Ángel Alexander Guardado.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Carolina Yamilet Hernandez.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Claudia Guadalupe Arias.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Claudia Ivette Samayoa.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Hilda Xiomara Soriano.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Irma de Los Ángeles Flores.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Jessica Rosemary Olmedo.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Joana Beatriz Orellana.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Karina Melissa Estrada. Linda Stephanie Ramirez.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Mayra Roxana Hernández.
Present, teacher. See you tomorrow.
See you. Miguel Ángel Domínguez.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Nelson Iván Alfaro.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Olga Marlene Gómez.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Zenaida América Domínguez.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Silvia Zuleima Rodríguez.
Teacher.
Silvia Enrique Cortés.
Present.
Carlos Alberto Meléndez.
Present.
And Carla Verónica Suria.
Present.
Okay, thank you for attending tonight. See you tomorrow, okay? Have a good night.
See you tomorrow, teacher. Have a nice night.
Bye-bye. Bye. Okay, Marisol, ¿algún tema que quisiera que reforcemos?
Por ahora, creo que todo bien.
Okay.
Yes.
Very good.
Yes, teacher. Solo hemos visto los como first, second, then, later, y luego los lo que estuvimos viendo ahora. What you need, if you need, if what you need is clear, teacher.
Okay, okay. Well, let's talk a little bit. To practice.
Okay.
Tell me about you. What you do, where you live, where you work.
Yes. I live in La Libertad. I work in a hotel. I am a receptionist and I make reservation and I need to speak with another people in English, and for sure I need to learn more English.
Yeah, and where exactly is the hotel, Palo Verde Hotel?
El Sonte, La Libertad.
In El Sonte. Ah, yes. That's a beautiful beach. I used to go to El Sonte. Yes.
Ah, you visit? Did you visit?
El Sonte, yes. I know El Sonte.
Oh, yes, it's beautiful.
Okay, and tell me about the hotel. So how much is the price? What are the services?
Yes, we have room with one king size bed for two people. The cost is 100 59 for two people per night. Taxes and breakfast is included. This is from Monday to Thursday. From Friday and Saturday is 290.
290?
For two people, yes.
Wow. It's,
for four people.
A little expensive.
Yes. For four people, 319.
Yes. Hey, and what
it's
are
a little expensive.
Yes, because it's very kind of expensive. Okay.
Yes.
And what else do they have in the hotel?
We have services. For example, massage and surf lessons and tours and just that. It's okay. In front of the beach. We have access to the beach. We have a beautiful pool.
A pool, yes. Okay. Do you have day pass?
Yes, we have. The price is 30 per person from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. It depends. If we have fully booked, we don't have day pass. Yes, it depends.
And what does the day pass include?
Day pass include use the pool and $10 is how do you say consumables?
Yeah, you can say yeah. Let me check. Sure.
Yes, I know.
Let's find out. Okay, so you can use $10.
Yes, in for food or drinks.
Oh, it's almost the same. Consumable.
Consumable.
Just the I change for A. Consumable.
Consumable. Okay. Yes.
$10 are consumable. Okay. Yes. So, when did you start working in that hotel?
For example, today, from 1 p.m. to 8 p.m. and tomorrow from 7, about a schedule or what is the question? Sorry.
Yeah, no, my question is when did you start working?
Yes. 4 years ago.
Okay. Yes. Okay. And what is your position now?
A receptionist?
Receptionist.
Yes.
I think I'm not sure if I know that hotel. I think I have been there, but I'm not sure.
Okay.
In El Sonte.
Yes.
Okay, very good. And how many rooms are there in the hotel?
10 rooms.
10 rooms?
There are 10 rooms, yes.
Okay. And yes. What is the best dish that they offer?
I'm sorry?
The best dish, food.
Yes, but the restaurant is separate from the hotel. It's another
different
administration, yes.
Oh.
It's different.
What is the same name of the restaurant?
Olor de Mar.
Olor de Mar is a different name.
Yes, it's a different name.
Okay, okay. And how many people work in the hotel?
40, about.
About 40 people?
Yes, 40.
It's good. It is good. Okay, and where have you studied English? Because you're
yes,
kind of good.
I was studying English in another academy, and now I study English in another course here at the school. Tuesday and Thursday in the afternoon.
What school?
It's a project by Bitcoin.
Bitcoin?
Yes.
Ah.
It's how do you say it's financiado?
You're financed.
Yes, by Bitcoin.
Oh, interesting. Yes. So you don't pay?
No. Oh. I don't pay.
Very good, very good. Good, nice opportunities.
Yes, nice.
And you have children?
Speak. No, I don't have.
I'm
single.
Okay. Yes. So there are a lot of tourists in the hotel. A lot of people speaking English?
Yes, sometimes only people in another country, and I need to speak English always.
Oh, yes. And the owner is someone from another country?
No, it's from El Salvador.
It's from El Salvador.
Yes.
Perfect. Okay, nice conversation.
Okay.
Thank you. So you're doing good.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Well, let's stop here. It's time to go to sleep.
Okay, teacher. See you tomorrow.
Okay. Bye-bye, Ana Marisol. Take care. Good night.
Thank you. You too.